Welcome students in the organic chemistry lecture series. Today in this video we are going to study about the another optical isomer, that is diastereomer. In previous video we have seen about enantiomer. In this video we have to see about diastereomer. Now as we know that enantiomers are the non-superimposable mirror images of each other. Non-superimposable mirror images of each other. Okay. But these diastereomers are non-superimposable but not mirror images of each other. So this is very important difference between enantiomer and diastereomer. Okay, so enantiomer are the mirror images of each other, but diastereomers are not the mirror images of each other. Another important thing is that for a molecule to show a diastereomer, it should have at least two asymmetric carbon atom. Compound should have at least two asymmetric carbon atoms. Then and only then a molecule can exhibit a pair of diastereoisomers. If there is only one asymmetric carbon atom, then there is a possibility of pair of enantiomer. But for a molecule to show diastereomers, then it should have a two asymmetric carbon atom. Now what is this asymmetric carbon atom that we will see? What is asymmetric carbon? So remember, a carbon atom which is attached to four different groups. Okay, so a carbon which is attached to four different groups is called as asymmetric carbon. It has another name, it is also called as chiral carbon, or it is also called as stereogenic center. So the meaning of asymmetric carbon, chiral carbon, and stereogenic center is same. Okay, so a carbon which is attached to four different group is called as asymmetric carbon or asymmetric chiral carbon, or it is also called as stereogenic center. Okay, so what we have seen, see the main important point. Enantiomer, what are enantiomer? They are non-superimposable mirror images of each other. We have seen in last lecture. But diastereomers are non-superimposable, but they are not the mirror images of each other. It is very important. A compound should have at least two chiral carbon atom to show a pair of diastereoisomers. And what is asymmetric carbon? A carbon atom which is attached to four different groups is called as asymmetric chiral carbon or stereogenic center. Okay, so number of stereoisomers in the molecule is calculated by the formula. Number of stereoisomers is equal to 2 raised to n. So where n is number of chiral carbon atoms. Okay, so if a molecule has two chiral carbon atoms, then it will have four stereoisomers. If it has three, like this, we can calculate for a number of stereoisomers in molecule is calculated by this formula. So this is very important you remember, 2 raised to n, where is n is a number of chiral carbon atoms. So I think it is very simple. What is enantiomer? What is diastereomer? What is asymmetric carbon atom? Now, after taking example, you will clearly understood that what is a diastereoisomer. So we will take example so that you will understand this concept. Okay. Now consider the example of three bromo, butanol, butan to all. Okay, we'll see this molecule and we'll see how the diastereoisomers are possible. Okay, now the structure of this molecule is like this. We'll draw the structure first. CH3, CH, OH. At three position there is a Br and CH3. So this is the structure of this molecule, and you will clearly observe here that this carbon atom is attached to four different groups: CH3, OH, hydrogen, and this group. This carbon atom is also attached to four different groups. That means this compound has two asymmetric carbon, Therefore, the number of stereoisomers for this molecule will be equal to 2 raised to 2 equal to 4. That means this compound can be can observed in four stereoisomers. Now, what are that four stereoisomers? We will draw in a Fischer projection formula. So first thing which we can draw is like this. First structure we can draw like this. Now see, longest carbon chain is this CH3. CH3 group will be on vertical line. Okay. Now first possibility is that this OH and Br groups are on same side. Okay. So this is one stereoisomer. Now if you draw its mirror image, then we get this structure Br, OH, H, H, CH3, CH3. Okay, so these two. Now another possibility is that suppose this OH group and Br group are on opposite side now. Okay, so CH3, CH3, H, and H. Now you draw the mirror image of this. So here is H, here will be OH, here will be Br, here will be H. CH3, CH3. Okay, so we'll give number to this structure. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, now you observe this four structure. This structure 1 and structure 2 are the enantiomers of each other. These two are the enantiomers of each other, right? Enantiomers, because they are non-superimposable mirror images of each other. Similarly, these two structures are also enantiomer of each other. But you see, structure number 1 and 3, structure number 1 and 3, these are diastereoisomers. Similarly, structure number 2 and 4, these are also diastereoisomers of each other. Okay, so you observe this structure 1 and 3, you will find that these two structures are not superimposable, and also they are not mirror images of each other. That's why these two are the diastereomers. Similarly, second and fourth structure is also नॉन सुपरइम्पोजिबल एंड ऑल्सो नॉट मिरर इमेज ऑफ मिरर इमेजेस, सो इट इज डायस्टेरियोमर. सो नाउ यू कैन इजिली डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन इनेंशियोमर एंड डायस्टेरियोमर्स. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट पॉइंट विच वी विल सी इज दैट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन इनेंशियोमर एंड डायस्टेरियोमर्स. ओके, सो विल सी द इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन इनेंशियोमर एंड डायस्टेरियोमर. डायस्टेरियोमर, ओके, सो इन फर्स्ट कॉलम वी विल राइट इनेंशियोमर, हियर वी विल राइट डायस्टीरियो मर्स. ओके, द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज दैट दीज आर ऑप्टिकल आइसोमर्स, ऑप्टिकल आइसोमर्स विच आर नॉन सुपर इम्पोजिबल. दिस वर्ड इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, नॉन सुपर इम्पोजिबल एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो इंपॉर्टेंट, मिरर इमेजेस ऑफ ईच अदर. ओके, ईच अदर एंड हियर इन डायस्टेरियोमर वी कैन राइट दे आर ऑल्सो ऑप्टिकल आइसोमर, ऑप्टिकल आइसोमर. ओके, दे आर ऑल्सो नॉन सुपर इम्पोजिबल, नॉन सुपर इम्पोजिबल बट दे आर नॉट मिरर इमेजेस ऑफ इच अदर. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, नॉट मिरर इमेजेस, दिस वर्ड इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. और सेकेंड इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज दैट मॉलिक्यूल विथ वन कायरल सेंटर कैन ऑल्सो एग्जिबिट इनेंशियोमर, बट हियर अ मॉलिक्यूल शुड हैव एटलीस्ट टू कायरल सेंटर्स. अ मॉलिक्यूल इन विच ओनली वन कायरल सेंटर इज देयर, डायस्टेरियोमर्स आर नॉट पॉसिबल. ओके, सो एटलीस्ट टू कायरल सेंटर्स आर देयर. अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज दैट फिजिकल एंड केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ इनेंशियोमर्स आर सेम, बट हियर फिजिकल एंड केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज आर नॉट सेम. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, फिजिकल एंड केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज आर नॉट सेम. देन अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज दैट दे हैव सेम केमिकल रिएक्टिविटी एंड डिफरेंट रेट ऑफ रिएक्शंस, दैट मीन्स वी कैन से केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज दे कैनॉट बी सेपरेटेड बाय फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, दे आर नॉट सेपरेटेड बाय फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन बिकॉज दे हैव सेम फिजिकल एंड केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज, दैट्स वाई इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू सेपरेट देम बाय फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन. बट डायस्टेरियोमर्स कैन बी सेपरेटेड सेपरेटेड बाय फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन. ओके, सो रिमेंबर दिस पॉइंट. एंड द लास्ट पॉइंट इज दैट they have same optical rotation, but diastereomers do not have same optical rotation. So these are the point of differences between enantiomers and diastereomers. So in this video we have seen in detail about diastereomers. Okay, with this we have completed the optical isomerism part. There are two types of optical isomers, that is enantiomer and diastereomer. In previous video we have seen enantiomer, in this video we have completed diastereomer. So I think this stereoisomers part is completed because we have two types of stereoisomers, geometrical isomers and optical isomers. And both these geometrical and optical isomers part is now completed. In next video, we will meet with another concept of this topic. So up till now, we will stop here. Have a nice day. Thank you.